I'm thirsty.
I don't think you should drink that. It looks bad for you.
Nonsense. It makes me feel great, smarter, more aggressive. I feel like I could. Like I could. Like I could.
Hamster! Just what I need for dissection lab tomorrow.
I think I need that for the band, Laverne. You know, like we could bite its head off or whatever.
Hands off that hamster!
Friend of yours, Bernard?
He belongs to Weird Ed Edison, and it looks like he's brought us a note. It's from my old friend, Green Tentacle. He says that Purple Tentacle's mutated into an insane genius, and Dr. Fred's going to kill them both! I thought I was free of Dr. Fred and those crazy Edisons forever. But now, I know that I must go back to the mansion! Okay, we'll spread out commando style. Laverne, you go secure the area behind those double doors. Hoagie, you take care of upstairs reconnaissance. I'll maintain command HQ here in the lobby.
What are we looking for?
We've got to find where Dr. Fred is holding the tentacles.
This better not take too long. I've got an anatomy final tomorrow.
And I've got a show to set up later tonight. If I'm late, I don't get to test the drums.
If I know Dr. Fred, he's got the tentacles tied up in his secret lab. Question is, where's his secret lab? Bottle of correctional fluid. That one looks like it's from a local hardware store. Help wanted. Lab assistant. Hardworking moronic drone needed to assist genius with experiments. High school diploma not required. It's stuck to the floor. Aha! A secret passage. This is all too easy.
Laverne, how'd you get upstairs?
Am I upstairs? I got lost.
Seen any tentacles?
What's a tentacle?
Oh, just something I whipped up in my spare time. Made good pets, actually. Until one of them tried to take over the world and to tie the little buggers up in the basement.
Good thing you told us that.
Yeah, Bernard wanted us to set them free.
Thank God you weren't that stupid. Did you say Bernard?
Okay, you're free to go.
Thanks, Bernard.
Yes, thank you, naive human. Now I can finish taking over the world.
Wait!
Oh, yeah. Now I remember. He's incredibly evil, isn't he?
I'll try to talk him out of it.
Well, what possible harm could one insane mutant tentacle do?
Leaping lab rats!
Dr. Fred!
What have you done this time, you meddling milquetoast? Now Purple Tentacle is free to use his evil mutant powers to take over the world and enslave all humanity!
Whoops!
Our only hope now is to turn off my sludge-o-matic machine and prevent the toxic mutagen from entering the river!
Isn't it a little late for that, Doctor?
Of course! That's why I'll have to do it! Yesterday! To the time machine!
This is all your fault, Bernard.
Behold, children! The Chron-o-John!
Doc, can't you just send Bernard?
No, you must all go to increase the odds that one of you will make it there alive!
Have any people ever been hurt in this thing?
Of course not! This is the first time I've ever tried it on people! Well, I'll be!
Bernard, float over here so I can punch you.
This must be that Woodstock place Mom and Dad are always talking about.
What could it all mean?
I don't know. I don't want to know.
Die! Die!
We may not live to see yesterday.
I'm sure Dr. Fred wouldn't have done this if it weren't safe.
After all, he is a doctor.
It worked! I can't believe it! And they said imitation diamond wasn't good enough. Uh-oh. Jewels?
What happened to Hoagie and Laverne?
I knew I should have bought a real diamond.
Are they alive?
My dials say that the larger specimen landed 200 years in the past, and the other is stuck 200 years in the future.
Well, hurry up and bring them back.
I will, as soon as I get a new diamond. Then all your buddies have to do is plug in their respective Chron-o-Johns and...
Plug them in? Where is Hoagie going to find an electrical outlet 200 years in the past?
Yes, well, he'll be needing my patented super battery then, won't he? Now, where did I put those patented super battery plans of mine?
Plans? How are we gonna get Hoagie plans?
Don't worry me with details, boy. Just help me find the plans. They're in this house somewhere.
Now what am I going to do?
I think I made myself perfectly clear. Step one, find plans. Step two, save world. Step three, get out of my house. Let's get cracking. Maybe I put them upstairs. That's got to be it. Upstairs!
It's Dr. Fred's design for a super battery. It's capable of storing up to 1 gigavolt with a charging time of only 0.01 seconds. Wow! I've got the plans!
Quick! We have to flush them to Hoagie!
How did you get over there?
My ingenious super battery design, please.
You really flushed them?
Yes!
Down the toilet?
No, through time! Using the highly sophisticated time flux hydraulic vortex chamber I've installed in each Chron-o-John, you can flush small inanimate objects to each other through time! Flush small inanimate objects to each other through time!
Hello? Dr. Fred, can you hear me? Drat.
Did you hear something?
No. Let's see if what's-his-name catches on.
Oh, great. I'm stuck in colonial times. Tentacles are taking over the world, and now the toilet's backing up.
Hoagie, come over here. It's your old pal, Dr. Fred.
Dr. Fred, how'd you get in there?
I want you to pick up those plans you see in the Chron-o-John, Hoagie. Bring them to Red Edison. He's my great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandfather. He'll know what to do.
You need the plans to make a super battery so you can plug in your Chron-o-John.
Okay, if you say so, Bernard.
Good boy. Does he have any experience with electronics?
Well, I once saw him take 3,000 volts directly through his head without batting an eye.
Didn't he pass out?
Well, he was already passed out when it happened.
Time for me to save the world, I guess.
So as soon as Hoagie gets that battery working, we're set.
I'm afraid not. We still need a diamond for the main unit. And your friend in the future needs power too, if she's still alive.
Alive?
Get me out of here! I like trees and everything, but this one has got to go.
Okay, I flushed it.
Thank you.
away. Only employees are allowed to use that lab coat.
Hey.
What is it?
You look kind of familiar.
Of course I do. I'm Red Edison, the inventor, not to mention owner of this inn. Perhaps you've seen my picture in some important scientific journal. Then again, maybe not.
Do you know Ben Franklin?
Franklin? I would never associate with that overstuffed goofball. He has the stupidest idea about glasses with one red lens and one blue one.
What are you doing?
I'm inventing, you simpleton. What's it look like I'm doing?
I know an inventor who looks a bit like you.
Well, it's not one of my sons, that's for sure. It appears that I, Red Edison, foremost genius of my day, am to be the last in a long line of gifted inventors. My nearly indistinguishable sons have decided that they want to be artists. I think it was Jed's idea. Or is it Ned? Ah, well, the left-handed one at any rate. Must be some sort of bad blood on their mother's side.
What are you inventing?
It's a piece of paper that will stick to things by itself. Rather ingenious, if I must say so myself.
Well, see you later.
You might if you cut that hair a bit shorter. What's this? Help wanted, moronic drone, assist genius, yada yada yada. Well, I'm the only genius around, and you look dumb enough. So pick up your lab coat and get to work. Say, that's a left-handed hammer, you know. I invented it myself. It was for my ungrateful slob of a left-handed son. Oh, well. Super battery, eh? Brilliant design. Sometimes I amaze myself. Now all I need is oil, vinegar, and some gold.
I hate that clown.
Hey, boy, you missed the party.
You and the clown were having a party?
No, no, last night. At the Novelty Good Salesman's Convention. I tell you, we Novelty Good Salesmen know how to have a good time.
Has anyone ever told you you look like Don Pardo?
That's strange. My wife says I look like Charles de Gaulle. So, want a cigar?
Sure, lay one of those Havanan babies on me.
Thought I was gonna blow your head off there, didn't you? Well, you were right! You shouldn't smoke. It's a bad habit. That cracks me up every time.
Yikes! Hey, Dr. Fred! We have to do something.
What do you suggest, college boy? No diamond for the central unit, no power for the Chron-o-Johns! A mutant monster of my own creation, roaming the countryside, taking over the world! It's a dark day for mad science.
Why can't we just fix the time machine?
It needs a whole new diamond. Now where am I going to get the money?
Bake sale?
Do you realize how much a diamond costs?
2 months of the groom's salary?
$2 million!
So, you've got money, don't you?
Well, I didn't get all the money I expected from that TV show about us. We had to rent out our mansion as a hotel just to make ends meet. If only I had signed that contract in time.
What contract?
Well, after that incident when I was possessed by a meteor from outer space, somebody decided to make a show about us, but they didn't pay us anything. All we got was a cut of the video game.
Wow, that thing made millions.
Yes, I forgot to sign the royalty contract in time, though. I still have it in my safe upstairs.
Let's go get the contract out of the safe and sign it.
I forgot the combination.
But that's so stupid, Dr. Fred.
I know. It gives my enormous brain nightmares. Every night I dream about opening the safe, but I find something horrible inside and slam it shut. Over and over again, night after night.
Is that why you drink so much coffee?
I haven't slept in 2 years.
We have to do something.
Yes, we have to get a new diamond.
How about catching Purple Tentacle?
He's long gone. Probably taking over the world as we speak. Soon we'll all be speaking, well, English, I guess.
What if we unpollute the river?
I could just shut off my sludge-o-matic machine, but it's too late.
You have a machine whose sole function is producing toxic waste?
You can't have a high-tech laboratory like this and not spew poisonous filth. All the other mad scientists would laugh.
Isn't there anything we can do?
Go diamond shopping!
Well, gotta go save the world.
Good luck! Thanks. I needed a little pick-me-up. Must open safe. Must sign contract. Must provide for family.
This beautiful 4,000 carat diamond can be yours today for the special rock bottom introductory price of $2 million. The number to call is 1-800-STAR-WARS. Don't miss this amazing once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
It's useless. No one will ever be interested in my design, so I'm ending my novelty inventing career right here in this tacky motel. How appropriate. I can't even do this right.
Gee, you look depressed.
What clued you in, Brainiac?
The gun was a good tip-off.
I'm having a crisis here, a warehouse of anguish. I'm a novelty goods designer by trade. I've come up with some fabulous ideas. The exploding lollipop, itching powder gum, and reverse 3D glasses, to name a few. The problem is, no one likes my designs. I send them all over the world and no one responds. I just wish someone would say they liked one just once. Oh, woe is me.
I like your design ideas.
Well, I didn't mean you.
Never mind. Green!
Bernard!
What are you doing up here?
Well, I couldn't stop Purple, and he's gonna go out and conquer the world, and I'm afraid of what he'll do if he catches me, if Dr. Fred doesn't find me first. Does that answer your question?
Yeah. Hey!
What's up, Bernard?
What do you suppose Purple's up to now?
Well, he wants to take over the world, so I figure he's up to something devious.
Conducting cryogenic experiments on small animals?
I wouldn't doubt it, but I was thinking more along the lines of politics.
How's your new band doing?
Green tea and the sushi platter? We're doing great! We've decided to really capitalize on our strongest quality as a band.
Provocative lyrical content?
Volume, man, volume! We have a chance to win a Grimy Award as the loudest new band. We're pulling out all the stops.
Weren't you looking for a new guitarist a while back?
Yes, but we decided to go with a guy who plays power tools instead. We can generate a lot more sound that way.
Are you working on an album?
Yeah, we're doing a CD called Rap on the Forehead. I've got a few tracks hooked up through the stereo if you want to hear them.
Have you gotten any airplay?
No, we're a little too experimental for most radio stations, but we have a huge following in the club scene.
That's great.
Yeah.
Wanna help me save the world?
I'm afraid to leave the room. In fact, I don't think I can even move from this spot. Purple scares the daylights out of me.
Why the litter box? Have you got a cat?
Don't ask.
How does a tentacle sit in a beanbag chair?
Oh, that part's easy. Getting back out of it is hard.
Can you actually use that bowling ball?
No, Purple brought that in here after he grew arms. He got really discouraged, though, because he doesn't have fingers.
Well, see you later, Green.
Yeah! Good luck in saving the world, B-Man!
Wow! This is loud! Whew! I think it's fake. Hey! Aren't you Weird Ed Edison, the paramilitary nut?
Why, yes, I... Hey, do I know you?
Yeah, I'm Bernard Bernoulli. I broke into your house 5 years ago, kidnapped your hamster, broke into your piggy bank.
Nope, doesn't ring a bell, but I can't remember much about that period anyway. My psychotherapist thinks something traumatic happened to me back then that I'm blocking out.
Does it have anything to do with a hamster?
All I know is that I used to have a cute white hamster with spots, and now I have a cute brown one with no spots. It used to worry me, and the nightmares would come. I'm much better now. I don't have those bad thoughts anymore. Now I collect stamps.
Nice hamster. Does he do tricks?
No, he just sits there. I used to have a really smart hamster, but something happened to him.
That's quite a nice collection. Can I have it?
No! I mean, no. They mean a lot to me. Sometimes I think they're the only friends I've got.
Are all your hobbies this fascinating?
I don't have any other hobbies. These stamps are my whole life. If anything were ever to happen to them...
How are the folks?
Well, Dad's in the basement doing an experiment. Mom's in the next room spying on a honeymoon. Ted's in the front yard.
Holding up a bowl of lard?
Well, it's a birdbath, actually, but it rhymes better your way.
Well, hope I didn't get you too excited. Bye!
Peace be with you.
Excuse me.
What is it? I'm rather... Say, aren't you Bernard Bernoulli?
Yes, that's right.
I knew it! You broke into our mansion a few years ago to save your little friend. What did you come for this time?
I'm a repairman. I've come to fix your VCR.
There's nothing wrong with my VCR! You keep your paws off of it!
How's Dr. Fred doing?
Well, he's still upset about the family financial situation, seeing that it's his fault and all, but he seems a lot better now that he stopped sleepwalking.
What's wrong with sleepwalking?
Ordinarily, nothing. But when Fred sleepwalks, he remembers a combination to the safe. I'd find him in the office, opening it, screaming like a cat in the oven, and slamming it again. Something about what's in there really scares him. Unfortunately, I was never able to catch the combination since he works it so fast.
How did he wreck the family finances?
Well, we should have made millions on the computer game they made about us. But the resident genius locked the contract in the safe in his office and forgot the combination.
How did he manage to stop sleepwalking?
He stopped sleeping. Fred drinks a lot of coffee. Me, I only drink decaf.
I was just admiring your statue.
Thank you. It's been in the Edison family since colonial times. One of Fred's ancestors carved it.
This is quite an array of gadgetry you have here.
Yes, it's the best surveillance system in the state.
Is that a Plexus 7000 VCR?
It sure is. It's got a dual tape speed motor with cobalt casing. Don't touch it.
Well, enough about your equipment.
Let's talk about yours!
I'll let you get back to what you are doing.
Come back anytime, you big hunk!
Thank you. It's pretty darn cold. I'm sorry to do this to you, little fella, but it's for the future of the whole planet. Neat! I'd rather not.
Excuse me. Yes? Whoa, you're like George Washington. Very much like him, according to my wife, Mrs. Washington. Awesome. Indeed. Weren't you president or something? Yes, I expect to be chosen president unanimously. I'm very well connected. Do you think I should be the ecology president or the education president? I think ecology is very important. Yes, of course, but what really matters is which one sounds better. Is it true about you and the cherry tree? Oh, yes, it's quite true. Why, I've cut down acres of cherry trees in my day. Would you give me a demonstration? I don't see why I should. Do you really have wooden teeth? As a matter of fact, I do make use of artificial teeth. I find them to be far superior to the ordinary enamel variety. Don't you have a problem with splinters? I've been to war, boy. No one who's heard the thunder of musket fire, smelled the sulfur from a cannon blast, and felt the fear in the hearts of his comrades is going to be bothered by a little thing like, oh, blast it. Well, what about dry rot? Hardly. My Uncle Henry has false teeth, too. Fascinating, I'm sure. What are you looking at out there? The future of our nation. Those outhouses? No, no. I was just admiring my reflection in the window. Striking, aren't I? I've been thinking about what you said about cherry trees. Pondering the great truths, eh? Well... I bet you've lost it. You couldn't cut down a tree to save your grandmother. Lost it, have I? Why, I'd show you a thing or two if there were a cherry tree nearby. But as you can see, there isn't. I only cut down cherry trees. Family tradition, you understand. Cherries only. There's nothing out there but cedar and kumquats. Hey, tall, dark, and spiffy. My name's Hoagie.
Well, how quaint. I am, of course, Thomas Jefferson, noted scholar, musician, horseman, student of the sciences, member of the bar.
Oh, sure, I've heard of you, dude. What's in the can, Tommy?
Thomas, my name is Thomas, and this, my chubby friend, is a time capsule, filled with remembrances of our time to be revealed 400 years hence.
Later, brah.
What? What's going to happen later?
Yo.
Hello?
What's up, you cold?
Cold? I'm freezing.
Why don't you build a fire?
Well, I keep asking Jefferson to build a fire, but he won't. Says he needs the log for posterity and won't part with it.
He's going to give the log to starving children?
I don't get any respect around here. Why, I bet if George I spent the winter in Valley Forge, Washington was cold, we'd get some heat in here.
Awesome blanket there, dude.
Thank you. It was given to me by my dear old colorblind Aunt Hattie.
Well, I gotta go, dude. George says that every American should have a vacuum cleaner in their basement. Boy, it's sure quiet in here. I wonder if there might be any ideas worth discussing in the suggestion box. Maybe somebody should take a look.
I say, lads, I have an idea.
Does it have anything to do with starting a fire?
No. I was thinking it's about time we open the suggestion box. Don't you agree?
Sure, George, if you say so.
Yes, whatever you think is fine with us.
Excellent.
What's he thinking? No one of any importance has been here all day. What could be in the suggestion box?
Perhaps he intends to suggest something himself.
Oh.
Ah, here's a suggestion. It says, George says that every American should have a vacuum cleaner in their basement. What do you think, gentlemen?
Whatever you say, George.
Your name's on it. I'm sure you must have a good reason for suggesting it.
Yes. It's strange. I don't quite... Well, I'm sure I had a reason for it. If there are no objections, we shall add it to the Constitution immediately. No? Good. And so shall it be law.
What's a vacuum cleaner?
Soon all the power of the heavens will be mine! All mine! If only we had some nasty weather!
Don't get your curls in an uproar. Excuse me, Mr. Washington. Boy, what a mess.
The water's all sudsy now.
You guys, I'll get to the flag next. I'm working as fast as I can.
Hey, chill. Take your time.
Don't tell me you've got another design change for the flag.
I've got another design change for the flag.
I knew it. What's the current brainstorm from our fickle founding fathers?
We need a babe in a leather bikini swinging a broadaxe.
Oh, what the heck. At this point, I'd do anything just to have it over with. Put the pattern on the table, and I'll look at it when I'm done with this job.
Thank you. This is exactly the sort of thing I need for the time capsule. I'll bury it tonight, and it won't be seen for hundreds of years. Future generations are in your debt.
Whoa.
I'll just run to the Chron-o-John.
There's something in the Chron-o-John.
Yourself.
Wow, you can talk.
Wow, so can you. What a coincidence.
I didn't think horses could talk.
Maybe they just never had anything to say to you. Ever think of that?
You mean horses have been snubbing me my whole life?
If you want to put it that way.
Is this some kind of a trick?
I don't do magic. I'm just a horse.
Nice teeth.
Thanks. I paid quite a bit for them.
Did I mention how great your teeth look?
Thanks again.
Did I mention how great your teeth look?
Thanks again.
What's a nice horse like you doing in a place like this?
Hey, I live here. What are you doing here?
I'm trying to get back to the future and save the world.
The future, huh? And I thought that Franklin guy was off his nut.
Well, I gotta go.
See you later.
Ahem. The LALR compiler is constructed by the following method. First, develop a rigorous elective grammar. If the elements have NP completeness, the crunchy factor can be ignored. Blah, 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 blah. Blah. Whoa. Question is, which one's stuffed and which one's the real McCoy?
I assure you that we are both real, but we are neither one of us McCoys. We are Edisons, Ned and Jed.
Who's who?
Does it really matter? Even our dear father can't tell us apart. He only knows that one of us is left-handed while the other is right, but that neither of us are following in his tiny scientific footsteps. Hold still, Jed! So, I'm almost too frightened to ask, are you the marble delivery man? Or the model?
I'm the model. Should I take my clothes off now?
No. No, you most definitely should not. We couldn't get your body shape right anyway, unless we cemented two slabs of marble together. But then your statue would have a big seam in it.
That's okay. It would have one anyway.
Look, don't call us. We'll call you.
Dang. I'm the delivery man, okay, if I unload in here?
Actually, we are well supplied with medium, so thank you, no.
I'm no marble delivery man, but rock is my life.
I'm sure that's terribly amusing, where you're from. Where exactly did you come from?
The future. Kind of spooky sounding, ain't it? Ooh, the future. I'm from the future. Look out.
Gosh, it would be so nice if you weren't here anymore.
Sorry, hope I haven't jostled you.
Too late. It. Oh, where hath gone the muse that once guided my hand with such care? Must inspiration be so transitory? Must art be so cruel? I'm a failure.
Don't say that, Ned.
Father was right. We Edisons are made to be scientists, not artists.
Dear brother, we must be strong in these times of creative adversity.
Why don't you let me take over for a while? I'll clean this rubble up and start over. You relax.
Have a cappuccino. I'm glad we switched places.
I think you're coming out quite well.
Sounds like the cats caught a moose up there. Thank you.
Excuse me.
Yes? I've been thinking about what you said about cherry trees.
Pondering the great truths, eh?
Well? I bet you've lost it. You couldn't cut down a tree to save your grandmother.
Lost it, have I? Why, I'd show you a thing or two if there were a cherry tree nearby. But as you can see, there... Oh, well, what do you know? There is a cherry tree out there. Well, let's go chop the sucker down.
I said come down from there at once!
Try to understand. I'm stuck in this...
Voila!
You're quite a man.
Yes, I know.
Get me out of here! I haven't done anything!
Well, you must have done something or you wouldn't be here now, would you? You'd be out in the lobby with your tentacle owner, getting dressed up for the human show.
Owner? No one owns me!
Gosh, no owner, you say? Well, don't worry about it. I'm sure someone will come adopt you before we have to put you to sleep.
Damn that, Dr. Fred.
Hey, she knows the Edison family motto.
Dr. Fred, is that you?
What? You're nuts. There hasn't been a Fred in the Edison family for 200 years. The last Fred was such a shame to the whole family, not to mention the whole human race.
Well, who are you then?
I'm Zed Edison. That's my wife Zedna, and my son Ved.
Nice to meet you. Where am I?
You're in the ancestral home of the once proud Edison family. We were once the masters of this house, just as humans were once the masters of Earth. Now we are the servants, the pets.
And not very good at either one, I might add.
Oh, get bent, you overdressed nightcrawler.
How do I get out of here?
If I knew that, do you think I'd be here?
What's this about a human show?
It's a degrading farce. That's what it is. These slimy tentacles put humans in humiliating little costumes, do sickening things to their hair, and then force them to parade their ridiculous talents in front of unqualified judges who are paid off weeks in advance.
Didn't get in, eh?
They said macrame wasn't a talent. Pointy-headed goons.
I heard that.
I'm tired of talking now. It's been a long day, and I'm only... human.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
What?
Ooh, I don't feel so good. I think I'm going to throw up all over.
Uh-oh. Time to visit Dr. Tentacle.
Well, well, what have we here?
I feel pukey.
Indeed. All right, now hold still.
Are you gonna use your scalpel?
No, of course not.
Darn. Do you want to use mine?
No.
What? What? What?
Just as I suspected.
What?
There's nothing wrong with you, human.
What a letdown.
Well, I'm late for the show. I'll send your keeper back for you. Oh, sit. Stay. Good boy.
I still don't understand how they can eat through a sucker. Hi. Hi, my name's Laverne. I'm a sophomore.
My name's Harold. I'm a thoroughbred.
Is your hair naturally blue?
Natural? Oh gosh, this took several very expensive sessions at a posh grooming salon. I've got the hair competition in the bag.
What are you, guys waiting for?
We're all waiting for the human show to begin, of course. If your owner's going to enter you, they'd better get you some name tags quick. But then again, why bother? My owner says I'm going to win. I'm the most beautiful human there is.
Hey, hold that thought. I got a boogie.
Keep in touch!
What's upstairs?
Nothing that you need to worry about. An old time capsule and some worthless human relics. And, of course, the showroom. Off limits to humans, naturally. Except for the showroom. I'll be off with you.
Hey, how'd you get out? Get back in there. I wish Dr. Tentacle would stop losing patience.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
What?
I have to go to the bathroom.
Ha, that's a good one. Imagine a human using a bathroom. Come on, let's take a walk. Okay, human, do your business.
I'll use the Chron-o-John.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
It's about time.
How about an amendment that the president has to be a human being?
Please, this is serious business.
You're right.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
What?
I have to go to the bathroom.
Oh, all right. Come on, let's take a walk. Okay, human, do your business. Thank you.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
It's about time.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
What?
Get me out of here! This is a violation of my rights.
Rights? You're a human. You don't have any rights.
Ooh, I don't feel so good.
Again?
Stupid tentacle. Looks like there's some kind of rodent down there. He was scratching his back on the fence, I think. This ought to be good. Well, what do we have here? Looks like a prosthetic rodent. Another specimen. It has three settings. Cook, jet defrost, and mutilate beyond recognition. Gosh, I hope this isn't like the primitive dangerous microwave ovens of my century. Those things could really pop a hamster good. Uh-oh. That was fun, but only because this is the 22nd century. You see, kids who put hamsters in microwaves back where I'm from get taken away from their parents and put up for adoption. So don't do it. Hello, I'm a tentacle. I'd like to enter my insignificant human in the show.
Oh my, yes, yes, of course. Take these tags and put them on your human and have them wait on the bench in the lobby. Entrance will be judged in three categories. Best smile, best hair, and best laugh.
Thank you, fellow tentacle. Unlike humans, you have been very useful.
Oh, thank you. Believe me, it was my pleasure.
Now all I need is a human.
Yowza! That was one good-looking tentacle.
Chateau de Cheap, 1775.
Everyone's raring to go. Let's get this show on the road.
Ah, here it comes. My finest hour.
The voice of Uzo in a box.
Thank you. nice outfit.
Don't bother. You'll just get beat like the rest of them.
And so I said to her, that's not my suction cup.
You think that's funny? Listen to this.
Well, you know what they say. If you want to save the world, you gotta push a few old ladies down the stairs.
Edison, Internal Revenue, come with us. We'd like to go over some of your records with you. Upstairs.
The tape's at the end.
Dr. Fred Edison, Internal Revenue, come with us.
I think I broke the button.
Did you say you have a PP-41 facilities paraphernalia declaration over there? Nope. What did you say your wife's name was again? Sandy. Oh yeah, what is it?
Are you guys brothers?
At the IRS, we're all brothers.
What have you done with Dr. Fred?
We've got him safely locked in the next room while we go over his books. No, you can't go in and see him. And don't even think about staging some kind of rescue.
Who's your tailor?
Very funny.
I'll just be moseying along.
Keep your nose clean, kid. Did you say you have a PP-41 facilities paraphernalia declaration over there? Nope. Hey, you can't go in there. What did you say your wife's name was again? Sandy. Oh, yeah.
Let's see, it's 101-99957.
Thank you.
Ted is red. See red Ted. It's stuck.
Thought I heard something. Everything okay in there? Well, try and keep it down, okay?
Nah, I'm not gonna make that mistake again. Oof! Dr. Fred, are you okay? Dr. Fred? I'd better get him to the lab. Well, I got him in here, but he's out cold. Dr. Fred, what do we do now?
We have to buy a diamond and plug it into the Chron-o-John.
Dum-de-dum. Look. looks like a big storm. See, this is why I never wash my car. Hey, Ben.
What do you want?
Where are you going? What about your experiment?
Even science sometimes gets cold on account of rain, my boy.
But how are you ever gonna get lightning if you're not gonna stand out in a storm?
To be frank, which I am, I don't know. The science of electrodynamics, much like your mind apparently, is still in a state of relative infancy. Back to the drawing board, I say.
What a genius. You're brilliant. What a novel design. Come to Baltimore at once.
I'm just a failure.
Hey, there's a letter here for you.
For me? Probably another rejection slip. Oh well. You're brilliant. What a novel design. Come to Baltimore at once.
It's pretty small. Someone wrote, "Wash me in the dust." Some people think that washing one's vehicle will make it rain.
Oh?
Uh-huh.
How about that?
Hi.
Don't sneak up on me like that.
What are you up to?
I locked my keys in the car.
I don't see your keys in the car.
Actually, I lost them somewhere.
If you're locked out, why break into the trunk?
I have a spare set of keys in there.
Here, perhaps these are your keys.
Where? Gimme. Hey, thanks, pal. Keep the crowbar.
Thank you, masked man.
What sort of person would carry around this many keys? It must be one of these.
Soaking wet. Now 1968? 1974? Ooh, 1977. Whew.
This ought to warm him up.
That's the second coolest pocket protector I've ever seen.
Huh? I don't see anything.
Oh, never mind. Hi there.
What can I do for you, kid?
So where is everybody?
The really big bash was last night. I guess they're all sleeping it off. So, want another cigar?
Okay, but only if you promise not to light it this time.
Would I do a thing like that? I don't get it. Get lost, kid.
What are you babbling about?
You really should have told the judges if you weren't feeling well.
Oh, ick! Now, how did that mess get in there? I think I'm going to be sick.
Someone in here not feeling well?
I was feeling fine until I saw that.
Is that your regurgitation?
No, I'm an LC human.
Didn't you just say you thought you were going to be sick?
That's just a figure of speech.
Do you realize you could have infected the whole show with human influenza?
But I just got all my shots.
You're a good-looking human, Harold, but you know the rules. You're out of the show. What a mess.
I hate cleaning up after humans.
Hmm.
Hey, when are you guys going to judge best hair?
Oh, all right.
Wow, that's the best hair I've ever seen on a mummy.
Thick and full.
And juicy.
The mummy wins.
Agreed.
Hey, when are you guys going to judge best smile?
Oh, all right.
I like the quiet one with the big teeth.
There's nothing in the rules about them being white.
First place goes to the mummy.
Agreed.
Hey, when are you guys going to judge best laugh?
Oh, all right.
Okay, who's got a joke?
Hey, I just flew in from Baltimore, and boy are my suction cups tired.
A classic.
It's amazing how the mummy can do that without moving his lips.
I say we give him first place.
Agreed.
Well, that makes him best of show.
Let's go congratulate him.
He is very well preserved.
I'll miss his laugh.
It's time to give him his winnings and start packing up. We gotta get this whole show to Baltimore by Thursday.
Yes, our work here is done.
Well, Ted, this is where we part ways. You've certainly helped save humanity. Even though you've been dead for thousands of years, I think you're my favorite Edison.
Tell me, Lieutenant, how do you really feel about humans?
Honestly, sir, I think they're filthy, obscene, foul, sickening, like the stuff in your eyes when you wake up, like the wax that builds up behind your suction cups after a few days, like...
That's enough, son. I just wanted to be sure you weren't one of those humanist sympathizers. What with this ridiculous human show going on here, there's humophiles everywhere.
I'm no humophile, sir.
That's good. Now, let me tell you about a little plan I have.
Say, cutie, what brings a hot tentacle babe like you to a dump like this?
Don't you recognize me?
No, hey, aren't you the waitress from Club Tentacle? I love that place. I'd be there right now if I weren't flat broke.
I'm here to see you, big boy.
Really? Well, what are you doing for dinner? How about Club Tentacle? Hey, what am I saying? I can't afford to take out the trash, let alone a classy babe like you.
I'm looking for a pet.
Sorry, honey. You came to the wrong place. These three are problem humans. Untrainable, disobedient, downright surly.
He's just jealous because we've got opposable thumbs.
Someday you will accept tentacles as your masters.
Huh. You losers can't even ride tricycles.
See why no one wants them as pets?
I'm here by accident. Bye.
Hey, I don't want to be here either.
Dinner for two at Club Tentacle. Dang, it says tentacles only.
Whoa! Dinner for two at Club Tentacle? I can't wait to tell my wife!
You're free!
Free to do what?
Free to run wild through the woods like humans should!
Big deal!
I said you're free, now get off your fat lazy butts and start enjoying it!
Enjoy being hunted for the rest of our lives by that mustached-old tentacle with a big net? If we ran off, he'd be right on our trail. If we stay here, we know we'll be warm and comfortable. Outside, we'd be eating bugs and moss.
You'll be eating my fist in a second.
The woods are filled with wild animals. Lions, tigers, and skunks. Man, I hate skunks. Hey, look! A skunk!
Come back here, you mangy human! You can't do this! This is an escape-proof facility!
Who says you can't learn anything from cartoons, eh, kitty?
Look at that sucker go! He just keeps running and running and running.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Mr. President, may I offer you an excellent smoke?
Can you also provide me with a light?
Sure.
Well, in that case...
happens. See if you can't find those for me, will you? There's a good lad.
Excuse me.
Yes?
You enunciate quite clearly for a man without his teeth.
I've had a bit of practice. Martha frequently hides them from me as a joke. Gee, I gotta go now. Could you use these? Why, thank you, young man. Strange. I wonder if I should cut down on the coffee.
Hey, Tom, look! The father of our nation is cold. Better build a fire.
You're right.
Huh?
I guess you can have my log.
Me? Why should I build the fire? You build the fire.
I'm bothered by the smoke. You build the fire.
I'm bothered by your attitude. You build the fire.
No, you build the fire, Mr. Penmanship.
No, you build the fire, log lover.
No, you build the fire.
No, you build the fire.
You big baby.
The idiot who started the fire. It's blocked up with somebody's bed. It looks pretty clear in here now. Say, did you get the pen on our way out?
No,
I found a blanket blocking the chimney.
Son, do you know anything about a blanket?
Didn't the dude next to you have one earlier?
Hey, catch you later.
Excellent! I need that for my super battery. Ah, the final element for my ingenious battery. Stand back, boy. Give me room to work. Miracle of modern science. It will look lovely here on the shelf until I take it with me to Baltimore.
Don't look now, but the British are coming, dude.
Eh? Where? Is that supposed to be funny? I'm very busy.
Hi.
Sorry, can't talk. Busy making history.
It looks kinda small for me. It looks kinda small for me. It looks kinda small for me. I got something good for you, mister. Mister.
Mr. Brainstorm? Yes, hand it over. Doesn't this belong to somebody?
Yeah, Red Edison.
Ah. I'm sorry, but the man has no vision. A lightweight, durable fabric like this going to waste down in his basement. When I'm done with it, it will fly. Eureka! The all-season Francocopter, ready to make history. No, there's no fuse.
So, what do I light?
For the last time, you're not going to light anything. You just push it.
The whole time? How am I going to get up that high?
Listen, just wait for me to say the word now. Then push the kite into the air, all right?
I'm on you, Lasagna.
Let's hope so. Now!
Oops.
What part of the word now didn't you understand?
Duh.
Look, it's very simple. I say now and you push the kite. Comprenez-vous?
Got it.
Marvelous! Now!
Whee!
She's handling kind of funny.
You got it. Just hang on there.
She's too heavy. I can't control her.
Hang on, Ben. Hang on.
She's breaking up. She's breaking up. Run for your life! Now that was interesting.
Yeah. Say, can I see that kite for a second?
No, I'm taking it back to my lab in Philly right now so I can study the results. Wish me luck. I never got your name.
It's Hoagie, sir.
Nice working with you, Hoagie. I promise to name an invention after you someday.
Gosh, thanks.
I got the contract for you to sign, Doctor.
Sorry, I don't like to sign things that I haven't read.
Okay, so read it first.
I'm busy trying to think of a way to save humanity. I don't have time to read. Now leave me alone.
Will you please sign this contract?
I don't sign things I haven't read.
Sign it, or I'll get real mad.
And do what? Not be my friend anymore? Ha ha ha!
Will you please sign this contract?
I don't sign things I haven't read.
But the whole human race is at risk.
Of course! That's why I'm busy trying to think of a way to save it! I don't have time to read. Now leave me alone.
Will you please sign this contract?
I don't sign things I haven't read.
Oh, forget it. I'll get rid of Purple Tentacle myself.
Oh, yeah? How?
I'm starting up a petition to ban all tentacles.
Wow! Where do I sign?
Right here.
Well, good luck.
Hey, wanna see a neat trick?
Sure.
Neat, huh?
My Pony Express stamps. You ruined my Pony Express stamps, not to mention 5 years of therapy. Get out of my room!
Jeez, what a grump. He should really try to find some outlet for those... negative feelings.
Yes, what do you want?
Hi there. Is this Dr. Fred Edison?
Who did you think you called? Dr. Spock? Look, I don't have all day.
This is Farley Crock at LucasArts Games. I just discovered your contract among some very old files, and, well, our lawyers say that we, have to pay you $2 million in back royalties. For the use of your family in the Maniac Mansion video game.
What?
This is Farley Crock.
No, I heard that, you moron. When do I get my money?
Oh, right now. It's been credited to your Swiss bank account.
Operator, get me a travel agent. This is an emergency.
Potato Shopping Channel, Wanda speaking.
I want to buy a diamond.
That will be $2 million. Do you have a major credit card?
I have a numbered Swiss bank account.
What's the number, sir?
It's 846-427-35327.
Very good, sir. We'll send the diamond by pronto post lightspeed delivery immediately. Thank you for calling.
Now that's service. I'd better get this to Dr. Fred right away.
That should do it. Where did you get this diamond anyway?
It was donated by a group of Girl Scouts who were in the neighborhood.
How heartwarming. According to my instruments, everything is in readiness. Your friends have activated their units, so it's time to throw the switch!
Great! Hoagie! I'm so happy to...
Hi!
Laverne! Wow! I'm so glad you two made it back okay.
I hate to interrupt, but there's no time to lose. Now that you're back, we've got to proceed with the original plan and send you back to yesterday to turn off the sludge-o-matic.
Huh?
Say what?
Now hold on a minute, Dr. Fred. They just barely made it back to our time alive, and I think...
Ha-ha! You can't turn off the machine if I get there first.
Uh-oh.
Don't worry, guys. This time I know I can stop him.
Uh-oh. I guess we better do something.
Let's go.
No, wait! You can't all go in the same stall. Didn't you see the fly?
We're
some kind of monster, dudes.
Great. Stuck here the rest of my life listening to Bernard talking and watching Hoagie eat. Mom warned me there'd be days like this.
Now, wait just a minute.
It's Purple Tentacle!
It's Green Tentacle. What was that dream?
Purple Tentacle behind you!
What?
I believe he's trying to warn you about me.
Oh.
We're going to turn off the sludge-o-matic and defeat your evil plan, overgrown worm.
You sorry lot are no match for me.
But there's three of us. Well, sort of.
Nevertheless, I mean to crush you.
Yeah?
You and what army?
Why, this army, of course.
Yikes.
You see, I've been busy. These are all versions of myself from the future. I've been bringing them back here using the Chron-o-John. Together, we will conquer the world. Mutant there. Go to the basement and guard the sludge-o-matic. No one is to touch the sludge-o-matic. Now, creature, I must decide what excruciating tortures to... Leave them to me. I've been itching for a chance to test out my newly completed diminuator.
Uh-oh.
Excuse me. Us.
All right, the rest of you come with me. Next stop, the world.
What do we do now?
Whoa.
It wears off.
Aha.
Run for it.
Damn. The battery must not have had time to recharge, but it will.
Shh! Maybe he won't find us.
Yoo-hoo! Where are you, human? Always conks out as I'm about to finish them off. Aha!
Uh-oh.
Take that. And this. Drat. Always conks out as I'm about to finish them off.
It's way too high. Hey! Where'd he go? Now we can turn off the machine and prevent all this tentacle mayhem from ever happening.
Well, I'm certainly glad that's over with.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
Leaving so soon? We haven't had the chance to get to know one another. You humans amount to very little.
Eek!
Run all you like, you insignificant insect. The human race is doomed.
Just what is it you have against humans, anyway?
Humans are our oppressors. They made us live in this horrible motel. They created us in ungainly forms, so we could not rise against them. Try walking around with your legs tied together and glue on your shoes, you'll see what I mean.
But humans also created the sludge-o-matic, which made you super intelligent.
Nonsense. I created that myself and sent it back through time. I knew Fred's mad scientist ego would make him use it. How's that for a paradox?
Who? Fred? But there's only one of him.
Right. Anyway, you can see why I detest humans.
Let's discuss your hatred of humans further.
What's to talk about? I detest the whole cackling, hand-wringing lot of you.
Sounds like you just hate Dr. Fred.
I suppose you're right about that. I didn't start out hating all humans, just Dr. Fred.
You're pretty handy with that ray gun.
Center of the forehead every time. Would you like a demonstration?
Why don't you zap Dr. Fred if you hate him so much?
Perhaps that would be entertaining. Oh, drat.
Surely we can talk this out.
Talk?
Surely.
Wait! You haven't heard the last of me. I'll be back, and the next time, the world and all its piffling inhabitants shall be mine. All mine. All mine.
Okay, little fella. Mail this to Siberia. Our work here is done. Now we can go home.
Well, kiddies, it's been more fun than a jumpsuit full of weasels. Now, kindly get your freakish hide out of my home.
Please, Dr. Fred, you've got to get us out of this mess. We look terrible, and we can't buy clothes off the rack.
I'm getting sort of used to it. Maybe we could go on the talk show circuit.
Help us, Dr. Edison. You're our only hope.
Oh, all right. Idiots! It seems you're not exactly the sideshow attraction you imagined. You're just three complete goofballs stuck in one suit of clothes.
Well, I'm glad that's taken care of. Looks like everything's back to normal.
Thank you.